Hey guys, what's up? It's PK Mario, and today there's actually several milestones that I'm reaching. Well, not all of them I'm necessarily reaching, but milestones that are that have to do with me, of course. But okay, let's just begin. First off, a couple hours from now, I will have been on Earthbound Amino for 1 year. Now, of course, if you want to, I'll probably be uploading a blog celebrating that or something like that onto Earthbound Amino. So, I mean, if you can already tell, this video is not going to be about that. However, something else, and I'm pretty sure you know by the title of this video, is also happening today. A certain album is turning 30 years old. Today, August 31st, 30 years ago, 1987, there was one album in particular that released that went on to become the second most iconic album ever to be released by a certain artist, and it ended up winning him 2 Grammy Awards, bringing his total Grammy Award count up to 11. So yeah, let's get that out of here. And this is also my favorite album of all time, Michael Jackson's Bad album. Now, I really like every single song on this album, and it was kind of hard to rank them all, because they're all really good songs. Even my least favorite is actually, I still think, is pretty good, but, there's just some that I didn't enjoy as much as others. So, yeah, let's get started. We are going to be ranking 11 tracks. We are going to be ranking all 11 tracks on the Bad album. Actually, I have the special edition version, so there's technically 18 tracks on this copy, and there's only 10 tracks on the record copy of the album, but of course, I'm only going to be counting the ones that were on original printings of the CD copies of the album. So yeah, there's 11 songs on CD copies, because there was a bonus track on there that you couldn't get on record copies. But enough rambling, let's get into the countdown. Number 11, Liberian Girl. Now, this song actually isn't all that bad, despite it taking the bottom spot on the list. But when it comes down to it, I just found this song to be weaker than the rest on the album. And that's really all that I've got to say about it. I mean, it's not exactly the greatest song Michael Jackson put out, but it's still pretty good, I guess. Number 10, I Just Can't Stop Loving You. This one is actually a duet with, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to pronounce her name wrong, Syda Garrett or something like that. It's a decent song. One of two duets on the album, and respect where it's due, it was the first single to be released for Bad, and until the album released, it was the only single available for the album. This song, I'm just not a big fan of, but I still like it. Number 9, Man in the Mirror. Now, I know that this one's a favorite for other people, and you know what, that's fine. I still really like this song. I like the message, but probably the best part about the song has to be the last couple minutes of it where, I don't like how it's all slow and stuff at first, but it really builds up at the end, and that's what I like about it. But I'm just not the biggest fan of this song. In my opinion, it is kind of overrated. Do not kill me. That is just my opinion. Number 8, The Way You Make Me Feel. This song I used to love, and if you were to ask me what my favorite song from the Bad album was, maybe about a year ago, I would have said this song. But just the fact that I've played it so much, I don't know, I just started getting sick of it, and, still a good song. I play it every once in a while, but, not exactly the greatest either. Michael has powerful vocals in this song, as he always does, and, I still like it for what it is. Number 7, Dirty Diana. Now if you were to ask me, maybe just a month or two ago, before I actually started to listen to this song a bit more, I would have told you that this would probably be the weakest track on the album. But now that I've actually gotten to listen to it more, I actually kind of like it a bit more. I like how it's sort of a hard rock slash almost heavy metal type of song. It's definitely more heavy metal than Beat It. I still do like Beat It better than Dirty Diana, but that's besides the point. Still a good song. Better than what I originally thought of it. That's all I've got to say. Number 6, the title track, aka Bad. Now I will address the elephant in the room. This song is way overused in children's movies. It was in the trailer for Despicable Me 3. Actually, no, it's in the soundtrack for Despicable Me 3. It was in the trailer for both Megamind and the Angry Birds movie. And those are just movies that I can think of off the top of my head. Is it a good song? Yes, of course it is. Any song from number 6 and up I would consider really good songs from the album. And, well, Bad is just a really good song. Ha ha. Kind of funny. Number 5, Speed Demon. This song wasn't technically released as a single. It kind of was, but as a promotional single. What I just said doesn't really make sense. I apologize for that. It's a good fast-paced song. And I feel as though it's the complete opposite of Bad, where it's underutilized in movies. I feel as though it could actually be used in chase sequences. It would be the perfect song, because it's got the fast pace, it's got the lyrics, it's got the tone, where there's someone being chased by a cop while they're on their motorcycle. Actually, Michael Jackson was given a ticket for speeding, and that's what inspired him to write this song. Quincy Jones told him to write about how he felt. And yeah, that's how Speed Demon happened. I would like to point out that the music video is really good for this song, despite it not being released as a single, because of its inclusion in the Moonwalker movie, which came out about a year after the Bad album. It was featured in there, and Michael Jackson was dressed up as a rabbit named Spike, trying to outrun the paparazzi as well as some crazed fans. I love the claymation in that video. I think his name is Will Vinton or something like that, but yeah, he really outdid himself with the claymation visuals. Anyway, number 4, Another Part of Me. This song is iconic. When people think of the Bat album, this is typically one of the first songs that come to mind. It was actually included in Michael Jackson's Moonwalker, the game, in the cemetery level, which, logically, you'd think that a game starring Michael Jackson would have Thriller in the cemetery level, but nope, Another Part of Me. This song actually barely made the cut over another song called Streetwalker, because one of the guys who listened to the song prior to the album's release started dancing to it, and that's the reason why it made it onto the album. And I think it was a good selection. Another Part of Me is a really good song. Number 3, Smooth Criminal. By far, this is probably, now Bad, of course, probably the most iconic song on the album, but Smooth Criminal comes in at a close second, because even if you just play someone the do 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 do, they'll say, hey, isn't that Smooth Criminal? Or at the very least, they'll say, hey, isn't that Michael Jackson? And, yeah, I just really like Smooth Criminal. I used to, a little bit after I held The Way You Make Me Feel as the, in regards as being the best song on the album, I held this song in regards as being the best song on the album. Still one of the greatest, and I even like the music video, probably one of the best of all time. But yeah, Smooth Criminal, also pretty good. Number 2, Leave Me Alone. Now, the title may give you the impression that this song is about a girl, as well as some of the lyrics, but no, it was actually about the paparazzi. Now, it was actually about the press. In the 80s, they were bad to Michael, but in the 1990s, they were flat-out obnoxious to him, especially with the child abuse allegations, which, I mean, thanks to Tom Sneddon and this one other guy that made a documentary, people now dismiss that as fact, because Wikipedia says it. I don't think that he abused a child, but anyway, Leave Me Alone. This song should have been used, this song is very good if you just want someone to leave you alone, and I think it's the perfect way to end off the Bad album. Definitely one of my favorite songs, and at some point it was my favorite song on the Bad album. But that leaves us with only one other song. Number 1, Just Good Friends. I'd like to start off by saying this song is underrated. It's a duet with Stevie Wonder, and, well, essentially, Michael Jackson, Stevie Wonder, two of my all-time favorite artists, put them together, you get a fantastic song. I am aware that the Characters album that Stevie Wonder put out had Get It, but this song is actually better. But yeah, this was the only song from the album that in no way, shape, or form was released as a single, which is kind of a shame. Just Good Friends is probably my favorite song ever, and of course that ultimately makes it my favorite song on the Bad album. So, yeah, what did you guys think? Do you agree with me, or if you want, comment your own favorite songs from the Bad album in the comments? But yeah, anyway, my iPad will most likely cut me off if I go on any longer. So, yeah, I'm just gonna end it here. Bye, guys.